Students, welcome back to the class 9. So in the last class we have started with the exercise, we have completed with the factor theorem, and also we have solved some of the examples. In this video you are going to learn, that is exercise number 2.4, and you are going to solve the first question, that is determine which of the following polynomials has x plus 1 a factor. That is, two examples I am given here, that is x cube plus x square plus x plus 1, and one more example I am taking, that is x raised to 4 plus x cube plus x square plus x plus 1. I am going to solve in the first main two examples, and two examples you have to solve by yourself. So how to solve, just to look at the example. So see here, determine which of the following polynomials has x plus 1 as a factor, means this first thing. So first step, what you have to do, x plus 1 you have to equate to 0, that x plus in the each and every part, for there are four question, in the four question just this part, x plus 1 is equals to 0, you have to equate equals to 0, it means x is equals to, if it is plus 1 it will become as minus 1, when LHS will goes to the RHS, plus changes to minus and minus changes to plus. Okay dear students, now consider, that is your part, that is p of x is equals to first, that is your example, that is x cube, next plus of x square, next plus of x plus 1. So this is your question, that is x cube plus x square plus x plus 1. Just substitute x is equals to minus 1. So if you substitute x is equals to minus 1, that is p of minus 1 is equals to minus 1 whole cube plus of minus 1 whole square plus of minus 1 of x plus of 1. So this is your, just I am substituting x is equals to minus 1. Okay dear students, I am substituting, if the number in the exponent is odd, means the sign will come this as negative. If the number is even, the sign will come as positive. If number is even, means so it is positive. Similarly, plus into minus is minus 1, remaining is plus 1. So now see, this is minus 1 plus 1, get cancelled. Again this is minus 1 plus 1, get cancelled. So the answer is 0. If the answer comes as 0, then you have to write x plus 1 is a factor of, x plus 1 is a factor of, you have to write, that is x plus, that is x cube plus x square plus x plus 1. Therefore, you have to write the conclusion as x plus 1 is a factor of x cube plus x square plus x plus 1. If it is equals to 0, if the answer is equals to 0, then only you can say x plus 1 is a factor of x cube plus x square plus x plus 1. If the answer is not equals to 0, if it is not equals to 0, if the answer will come such as 1, then you have to write the conclusion as x plus 1 is not a factor of x cube plus x square plus x plus 1. Here the answer is 0, means you have to write that x plus 1 is a factor of x cube plus x square plus x plus 1. Okay dear students, this is first example. One more example will come to know. So that is, one more example I am going to solve. Just I will change the p of x. Again the same procedure, you have to go x plus 1 is equals to 0, x is equals to minus 1. The second question of the first main says, that is x raised to 4 plus of x cube plus of x cube plus x square plus x square plus of x plus 1, means you have to write the p of x here, this is p of x. So again substitute x is equals to minus 1. If you substitute x is equals to minus 1, means p of minus 1 means minus 1 whole raised to 4 plus minus 1 whole cube plus of minus 1 whole square plus of minus 1 plus of 1. Okay, so see here, whenever the exponent is even, you have to write the positive 1. Similarly, when the number is odd, you have to write the negative 1. When 1 raised to something, whenever the number is 1 raised to even, means you have to write the same number. When the number is odd, you have to write the negative. Negative number is minus 1, and whenever the number is even, you have to write the positive 1. Okay, so just you have to remember this, only in the form of 1, not in the other forms. Okay, so dear students, so this is 1 plus into minus is, this is minus 1, this is again plus 1, okay, again this is minus 1, and this is plus 1. Okay, so see here dear students, so this is 1 minus 1, and this is plus 1 minus 1. So this is plus 1 minus 1 get cancelled, plus 1 minus 1 get cancelled. The answer we get this as 1. So P of minus 1 we get this as 1. Hence it is not equals to 0, means you have to write the conclusion as x plus 1. X plus 1 is not a factor, is not a factor of what it is. Oh yeah, is not a factor of x raised to 4 plus of x cube plus x square plus x plus 1. Okay, so x plus 1 is not a factor of x raised to 4 plus x cube plus x square plus x plus 1. So this is the first main part of two examples, and some more two examples are there, you have to solve by yourself. Okay, hello dear students, now welcome back to the exercise number 2.4. In the exercise number 2.4, I am going to solve the second question of your exercise number, that is 2.4. In the exercise number 2.4, that second question says, use the factor theorem. So use the factor theorem to determine whether g of x is a factor of p of x in each of the following cases. So you know the factor theorem. So you know the factor theorem, that is p of x is equals to, that is, yeah, p of x is equals to, yeah, that is x minus a into q of x, where r is equals to, we have substituted 0, so this is your factor theorem. We have to check that is x minus a is a factor of p of x. You have to check this theorem. Okay, so this is the factor theorem statement. So use the factor theorem to determine whether g of x is a factor of p of x in each of the following cases. If it is equals to 0, if I divide this x plus 1, if I substitute this g of x in the x value, I get a minus 1. If I substitute minus 1 in this, then if you get answer as x is equals to 0, then x plus 1 is a factor of 2x cube plus x square minus 2x minus 1. So by solving the examples, you will come to know. So what is the question says? So just write p of x. First I will write g of x is equals to, in this question we have, it is x plus 1, which is equals to 0, means x is equals to, we have minus 1. So x is equals to minus 1 means we have, that is p of x is equals to, the question as, that is 2x cube plus x square minus 2x minus 1, means just substitute x is equals to minus 1 in this polynomial expression, that is p of minus 1. So p of minus 1 is equals to 2 of minus 1 whole cube plus of x square, means minus 1 whole square minus 2 of minus 1 minus of 1. So here just I substitute this is, you are getting this as 2. So again it is in the form of u, again it is in the form of odd. Now 1 is in the form of odd exponent, means you have to decide right as minus 2. So this is plus 1, so again this is plus 2, this is minus 1. Okay dear students, so now this is minus 2, let's get cancelled, plus 1 minus 1 get cancelled, which is equals to 0. If the answer is 0, then you have to write that x plus 1, that is you have to write that x plus 1, that is g of x x plus 1 is factor of p of x. What is your p of x? P of x is nothing but your 2x cube plus x square minus of 2x minus 1. Finally, you have to write the conclusion as g of x is equals to x plus 1 is a factor of p of x, means that is p of x is nothing but 2x cube plus x square minus 2x minus 1. If it is equals to 0, then only we can say that is g of x is a factor of p of x. If it is not equals to 0, means you have to write g of x is not a factor of p of x. Okay, one more example I am going to solve. So this is same. So see here, next example, g of x, they are given as x plus 2. Next, second example is p of x is equals to x cube plus 3x square plus 3x plus 1, and this is g of x is equals to x plus 2, means this x plus 2 we have to equate to 0, and this will get x is equals to, you are getting this as minus of 2. Again you have to change the p of x. So what is your p of x? That is x cube plus 3x square plus 3x square plus 3x plus 3x plus 1. So this you have to change p of minus of 2. So this is minus 2 whole cube plus 3 of minus 2 whole square plus 3 of minus 2 plus 1. Okay. So just I change x is equals to, just you have to put x is equals to minus 2. If I substitute this, we'll get this as minus 8, and this will get this as 2 square is 4, because this is even, so it is, the answer will come, this is 3, 4 is, that is 4, 3 is 12. So because, why would this 4 means, this is minus 2 into minus 2 into minus 2, so 2 2 is 4, 4 2 is 8, minus into plus is minus into minus is plus into minus is minus, so this is will come as minus 8. Similarly, this is 3 into minus 2 whole square, means 3 into minus 2 into minus 2, which is equals to, we are getting this as minus into minus is plus 4, 2 2 is 4 and 4 3 is, are getting this as 12, so this is plus 12. Okay, and one more thing, so this is minus 6 and this is plus 1, 3 2 is 6 plus into minus is minus. Okay dear students, minus 8 minus 6 is minus 14, 12 plus 1, 12 plus 1 is plus 13. So again, this is 14 minus of 13 is minus 1, means minus 1 is not equals to 0. Minus 1 is not equals to 0 means you should write that x plus 2, that is g of x, that is x plus 2, g of x plus 2 is not a factor, is not a factor of p of x, that is, what is your p of x, draw it here, p of x is x cube plus 3x square plus 3x plus 1. Okay dear students, so please note down these two problems, that is second main part. In the second main part, there are two questions I have solved, and one more examples you have to solve by